going backpacking. I'm nervous about it being cold, there being critters, all those little things, but I'm super excited because we're going right next to the Golden Gate Bridge. We will be able to just cook some meal, have a good quality time. Yeah, just some nature, just to get away from the day-to-day lockdown of quarantine and being home. Here I have my day backpack. Have some masks, a film camera, this water pack, sun hat. This is the power pack. This one, like a smelly items bag. That's because, you know, the raccoons are out to get those. My face wipes, cleaning wipes, and then yeah, my makeup or sunblock, floss, toothbrush. And here is my big old blister moleskin, toilet seat covers, because I don't like porta potties. I feel like this is a way for me to feel okay. Hand warmers. So lastly, you can unzip this whole backpack, which is great for organizing. I have my sleeping bag, my sleeping pad, layers, a hat, a scarf to keep warm, camping chair. Then I have my hiking shoes and Birks. These are just the equipments for cooking. You need a stove, a pot, a spork, bowl, matches, and gas. The items I've listed you can find also in REI and Sports Basement. For groceries, I recommend getting snacks like fresh fruits, bananas, apples, something savory, and something sweet. For dinner, we're making vegetarian enchiladas. You'll see these ingredients again, but listing it here for easy reference. Lastly, other essentials. I recommend headlamps or flashlights. Sometimes the phones work, but you also don't want to carry your phone to the porta potty and drop it in the porta potty. Trash bags. Often you do have to pack the trash out. Tent, or a different type of sheltering system if you have one. First aid kit. Biodegradable dish soap and rag. That's it for the packing list. So these are just essentials. You can go as fancy as you want and bring whatever you like.
Sleep in a tent.
No.
Why not?
Look at it.
Okay. So here's our stove.
I really thought this was the stove.
No, open that and see what's in there. Backpacking, actually for all camping, because twist this on here, put the pot on, and cook our one pot meal.
This is...
So the plan is we're going to make enchilada bowls. We've got our beans, corn, and our tomatoes. And then our secret weapon, the soy rizo. The pro tip for backpacking and camping is one pot meals. Because anything more is way too much effort.
I mean, if your stove can only be this big, yeah, it makes sense that even you're...
Have you seen the... If the next size up is like a 10 pounder.
Yeah, I think that's what we use when we camp. That's what I'm used to.
How do you feel?
I'm learning so much.
There's some hesitation. I'm almost that I would break, mm-hmm. And then you accelerate. So you start slow, and then you just go, and then you go like accelerate until super speed.
I love the smell of matches. Ooh! Oh shit!
Now to save weight, I only have one utensil.
I hate all of this. I'm loving it in a way that I'm just like, would I ever do this on my own? No, this is too much. Like all of it, you think?
Yeah.
Oh, seasoning mix.
Taco seasoning.
I trust you.
Okay, next, you have a very important test.
Oh boy.
Tortillas. Yeah, that's good. I was waiting for that last rip.
Let it soak the juice up. Oh my god, I'm so shocked. I don't even know.
One pot, wow.
Yeah, one pot meal.
See, and no prep, the other thing. No cutting boards.
No, yeah. Mm. I have never truly camped, is what I'm learning, really. The moral of the story here is what I said. Yeah, I have experience. I don't. I have no experience.
How do you feel about birds?
That face.
How does Brett feel about birds?
Brett's like, oh boy!
Saying that right now. What is Brett doing? He is indeed. Oh god.
Honestly, I wonder if those are those three like attacking that one? Like that's like a different bird, right?
You hear that primal scream?
Yeah. I once saw an owl at today, it was an owl, and then there's like four crows attacking this owl.